The 30 warriors used traditional canoes built in their islands and brought to Australia to stop coal ships from entering and leaving the port for the day. They want to send a strong message and voice opposition to the Australian government's plans to double coal exports and drastically increase coal seam gas extraction, a move which they say is threatening the environmental safety of their homelands.
You've watched a few documentaries about the King's Tide and all this, you know, and our land, the water is rising, and our land is only 2 to 3 meters above water. The highest point you can go is to climb a coconut tree.
Pacific Islands will bear the brunt of climate change, with increasing sea levels, floods, and intense storms. Amelia Telford, NAIDOC's Youth of the Year recipient from the Bundjalung Nation, is the Indigenous Coordinator for the Australian Youth Climate Coalition. Amelia joined the blockade, paddling out in solidarity to stop the large vessels.
This is an event that was in, so the blocking the Newcastle coal port, the world's largest coal port, has been in the plans for the last year. The 350 Pacific, they've been working on this with 12 Pacific Island nations, brothers and sisters all throughout the islands who are being directly impacted by choices that are being made in Australia today.
Amelia says the Australian government's lack of action on this issue has prompted young Indigenous people to make a stand with their First Nations brothers and sisters.
I've been working on, the issue of climate change for quite a while now, and often it can be quite an upsetting issue because we're, when I was out on the water, we were just, small canoes facing this massive coal ship, and it puts us into perspective about how big it is, like how big the power is that we're facing. But it was so inspiring because it showed that as people we can stop this.
Michaela Maeva, a warrior from Tokelau, said that after years of failed global climate change negotiations, it was essential for the warriors to take direct action to stop climate change. Maeva specifically targeted the Australian government for its lack of action on this issue.
This is not a time to continue to hear about politicians and leaders just talk about it. This is the time for action, and this is why we're here. We are putting our talk into action, and we are bringing the spirits of the warriors, that we fight to live.
Danny Teece Johnson, Brand ITV News.